Welcome to this F40 PH-2CAT diesel-electric locomotive in Caltrain livery hauling Nippon Sharyo gallery cars. This brief introduction will cover passenger operations and recovery from an emergency stop. Climb aboard to get started. A lot of time will be spent in the engineer's seat. The locomotive's auxiliary systems are now ready to be energized. Give a quick glance of the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors. It's time to get going. Set the doors to locked. The reverser is used to set the direction of travel. The automatic brake is used for normal line operations. Increase the throttle to start moving. Do not apply too much power too quickly. With the train now moving, use the throttle and the brakes to reach and maintain the indicated speed. Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce engine stress and maintenance requirements. This locomotive features a manually lapped brake system. To operate the brakes, move the handle into service to achieve the desired pressure or braking rate, and once a desired pressure is reached, move the handle into lap to maintain it. Move the handle back to release to reset the system. Apply a small amount of brake force to achieve a comfortable, safe stop. It's time to get going. Set the doors to locked. Now try operating the train to the next station without instruction. Be aware that an emergency stop will occur before reaching the next station. To recover the train from this situation, the controls must first be reset. Use the independent brake to hold the train. The train has reset, so it is possible to get moving again. Return to line speed as before, and get ready to stop at the next station. Remember to apply the brakes early and gently so as to provide a comfortable ride for passengers. Well done. Practice makes perfect. Give it. Good work. That concludes all the basics of this locomotive. More details on the controls of this locomotive can be found in the manual. Welcome to this Nippon Sharyo gallery cab car in Caltrain livery, being powered by an F40 PH-2 CAT at the rear. This brief introduction will cover passenger operation and recovery from an emergency stop. Climb aboard to get started. A lot of time will be spent in the engineer's seat. The locomotive's auxiliary systems are now ready to be energized. Give a quick glance of the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors. It's time to get going. Set the doors to locked. The reverser is used to set the direction of travel. The automatic brake is used for normal line operations. Increase the throttle to start moving. Do not apply too much power too quickly. With the train now moving, use the throttle and the brakes to reach and maintain the indicated speed. Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce engine stress and maintenance requirements. This locomotive features a manually lapped brake system. To operate the brakes, move the handle into service to achieve the desired pressure or braking rate, and once a desired pressure is reached, move the handle into lap to maintain it. Move the handle back to release to reset the system. It's time to get going. Set the doors to locked. Now try operating the train to the next station, without instruction. Be aware that an emergency stop will occur before reaching the next station. To recover the train from this situation, the controls must first be reset. The train has reset, so it is possible to get moving again. Return to line speed as before, and get ready to stop at the next station. Remember to apply the brakes early and gently so as to provide a comfortable ride for passengers. Good work. That concludes all the basics of this locomotive. More details on the controls of this locomotive can be found in the manual. Welcome to this Union Pacific GP38-2 diesel electric locomotive. This brief introduction will cover startup and stopping operations. Climb aboard to get started. Lights help an engineer see inside the engine room. A lot of time will be spent in the engineer's seat. The locomotive's auxiliary systems are now ready to be energized. The power unit is ready to be started. Head over to the engine room. The power unit requires the fuel to be primed before starting. The power unit is now ready to start. With the power unit running, head back to the cab. The locomotive controls are currently isolated. Adjust the isolator in order to use them. Return to the engineer's seat to continue. The brake mode needs to be set in order to take control of the brakes of the train from this cab. Releasing the automatic brake will allow the air system to charge. The independent brake can now be applied to hold the train. The locomotive's brakes must be charged before they can be applied. With the independent brake holding the train, release the handbrake. To get the train ready to move, insert the reverser handle. The reverser is used to set the direction of travel. Interior lights let you see the cab better. Exterior lights are important in letting others around know that this is an operational train. To prevent the train from rolling back, apply a small amount of throttle as instructed. It's time to get moving. Release the independent brake. Increase the throttle to start moving. Do not apply too much power too quickly. With the train now moving, it's possible to apply more power and focus can be diverted towards achieving a desired speed. Coasting is a method used on flat gradients to efficiently maintain a constant speed and reduce engine stress and maintenance requirements. There's a short distance between here and the end of Newell Yard. Attention can be diverted to judging the required braking distance and preparing to stop. Apply a small amount of brake force to achieve a comfortable, safe stop. Well done. Practice makes perfect. That concludes all the basics of this locomotive.